from WPTV. This is Today on 5 at 11.
Hey, coming up, we're taking a walk on Wall Street.
Yep, next, this week's round of potential risks for the stock market. We'll be right back.
Hey, we're continuing our Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise Monday with a walk on Wall Street. This is Tyler Vernon. He is the CEO of Biltmore Capital joining us now. And first of all, thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule.
Great to be here, Mike.
Let's answer some questions. Let's talk about the economy, shall we? Is it really slowing down? And ooh, the dreaded R word. Are we headed toward another recession?
You know, a lot of our clients are asking us these questions. I think as we look at this economic expansion, this is actually one of the longest ones in history.
Wow.
By June, if we continue to get along, which we think we will, this will be the longest expansion since the American Civil War.
Wow.
And as we look at 2018, we define this expansion as one that's sort of like the stalwart tortoise that continues to slowly move ahead.
Okay.
Last year, we had the effects of the tax cut. It was sort of like this shot of espresso that the economy got. And we had over the underlying money went down to American consumers and small businesses. They spent that money. We had over 3% year-over-year growth. Now, as we get into 2019, the effects of those tax cuts are gone.
Mm-hmm.
Typically, in the first quarter, we get poor performance anyway, because it's cold up north, right?
Sure,
so
sure.
People come down here. They don't spend as much. But additionally, we had this government shutdown that's going to peel some off GDP growth. But as we look at second, third, and fourth quarter growth, I think when we look back at 2019, we're going to get a good 2% plus rate of growth. And specifically, the Fed governor, Powell, had a big turn of events. Last year, he said we're going to increase rates 3 times. We were very worried at Biltmore Capital about the effects of the economy.
Right.
Now he's come out and said potentially no increases this year, which is very, very positive for the U.S. economy.
So it looks like the economy holding steady at least for now.
I think it's going to be a great run.
Because sometimes when it gets too good, we're like, oh, something's going to happen bad.
Yep, but maybe, waiting for that shoe to fall.
Yeah, maybe not yet, though. Okay, the bull market, longest in history. You've been talking about this.
Yep.
Is it about to end? Is it time to sell? Like, what should we be doing here?
You know, I think this has been one of the most underappreciated bull markets in the last 100 years.
Wow.
And I think the reason for that is that we've seen very tepid GDP growth, as we talked about. It's come in at 1% and 2%. And on top of that, American workers just aren't feeling this robust earnings growth. We've had very stagnant earnings growth over time. So what happens is people just go ahead and sell, like in December, as soon as we see any kind of negative news. But as investors, we look at bubbles, and we haven't really seen any specific asset classes that are really highly valuated, whether that's individual areas of the market. Certainly certain stocks in some cases are overvalued. But even in the real estate markets, we don't see any areas of bubbliness. So I think that the economy can continue, the market continue to tread on. And we also look at unemployment. Unemployment, while at 50-year lows, can continue to drop. And what does that mean? It means more wages. It means more spending. It means more profits at U.S. corporations.
Okay.
So I think as long as the Fed remains dovish, I think we have a wind at our backs, and I think we'll see higher and higher markets in 2019.
Let me get to one more quickly. How can we borrow money cheap while those interest rates are maybe increasing, maybe not? What would you advise there?
Well, you know, it's interesting. As interest rates continue to go up, things like mortgages and credit cards and student loans and auto loans, they're all tied to the Fed, to the policies.
Correct, yeah.
And when you go down traditional borrowing routes like mortgages, and there's some risk to the lenders. So if they want to get you out of those houses, they have to go ahead and evict you, and it's a big pain in the butt. So as such, there's a premium to this type of lending. So your viewers out there that have portfolios of stocks and bonds and mutual funds, they have the ability to borrow against those instead. It's a little bit atypical, but there's no closing costs, and we can get rates down at 2.75%. So Biltmore Capital has negotiated some of the lowest rates in the country, where people are borrowing, you know, smaller amounts of money or larger amounts of money at 2.75%. So I would encourage your investors who are watching this, they can go to their Merrill Lynch's or their Morgan Stanley's or their, you know, Schwab's and Fidelity's and ask about margin lending. That's this type of lending that I'm talking about.
Okay.
And if that doesn't work, you know, we're here at Biltmore Capital as well.
Well, hopefully we've calmed some concerns, answered some questions. Again, that's Tyler Vernon, the CEO of Biltmore Capital. Thanks for coming in today.
All right, Mike, thank you.
Erica, back to you.